Hello video creators, thanks for watching and welcome to Storysium. In this Premiere Pro tutorial, I'm going to show you two ways to add text behind moving objects. The first method is quick and easy, but it won't work on every type of shot. And the second method takes a lot more time, but this will work in a lot more scenarios. Let's now jump over to Premiere and find out which method works for your footage. The first method works best with a clip that has a high contrast and the subject in the foreground should be darker than the background, similar to the silhouette shot that I've got here ready on the timeline. First, I'm going to add some text with the type tool, which you can enable here. Then I can add the text box and then type text, literally. I also need to resize the text box to make the last character visible. And let's also reposition the text, something like this will do. And then we also need to make sure that the text layer covers the entire clip. Then make sure you've got the text layer selected and then head over to the effects control panel to the opacity section. And here we're going to play around with the blend mode. In this case, the red text is a little lighter than the dark foreground, so that's why I'm going to select darken. This will blend the red text with anything that is darker on the tracks below. The downside of this method is that it will place all the darker parts to the foreground. And in this example, the darken blend mode also blends the colors of the sky. But it will look like this if I change the blend mode to darker color. But in the next example, the darker color option breaks the text. In this case, multiply, darken, or linear burn might be the best blend option. Also, the text color and saturation of the color matters for this blend mode method. So to summarize, this method can be quick and easy, but not suitable for every type of footage. Next, we're going to look at the second method, and for this one, I'm going to use this drone shot that I made a few years ago during my visit on Iceland. And in this example, we're going to add the text partially behind the mountain and then reveal it. We're going to start here by moving back to the first frame of the clip. Also here, I'm going to select the type tool, then make a text box and add some text. And here I'm going to type Iceland and then exit type mode and reposition the text. I think that something like this will work. Next, I will also extend the duration of the text layer so it will match with the clip. If I scrub to the timeline, you can see the position of the rocks at the beginning of the clip and also at the end. So this means that we need to hide and reveal the letters I and C. And to make this happen, we'll first need to duplicate the video track. We're going to do this by holding the Alt key combined with the left mouse button and then drag this to the third track. Next, make sure you've got the third track selected and then head over to the effects control panel. And for now, I'm going to lower the opacity to 95%. Now you can barely see the text that is between the two video layers, but that's enough to make a mask. To add a mask, we need to click on this pen icon here in the opacity section to enable the free draw Bezier tool. And then I'll click on this pull-down menu in the program monitor and then zoom in 250%. And this way I can work more precisely. And now I can start left-clicking in the program monitor to create a mask around the edges of the rocks. Just take your time to make this mask as precise as possible. In this case, a more precise mask will look a lot better. But these details only matter at the edge of the rock. So to finish the mask shape, we can make something like this. Okay, the first mask is done, but we can still slightly see the text here. And that's because we earlier set the opacity to 95%. So let's set it back to 100. Next, I also want to change the feather option for the mask. As you can see, the outside of the mask is a little blurry. So that's why I'm going to lower the feather from 10 pixels to 3. And here you can clearly see the difference zoomed in at 400%. Okay, so now we made the mask for the first frame and it looks pretty good to me. But if I now move a couple of frames forward, you can see that the mask doesn't move along with the rocks. We can change the position of the mask by enabling keyframes for the mask path. To do this, we first need to select the top video layer, and then inside the effects control panel, we need to click on this stopwatch icon next to mask path to enable keyframes. I will move this first keyframe to the beginning of the clip because it has mask position values for the first frame. Then select the mask again and reposition the mask. Also adjust the mask where needed to match with the rest of the rocks. And then simply scrub to the timeline to check if any other adjustments are needed. And as I said before, the more time you take to perfect the mask, the better it will look. Now we can just keep moving forward and adjust the mask where needed. And as you can see here, every adjustment to the mask creates a new keyframe. and we'll do this until both letters are revealed behind the mask. Okay, this should be good enough for this tutorial. Let's have a look at the results. And that's it for this short Premiere Pro tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, you might also want to check out this video where I show you 4 more creative masking examples. Anyway, as always, thanks a lot for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.